All right, guys, I'm going to show you guys today how to use a cash flow statement for a restaurant. So hopefully my screen sharing abilities have improved, and I'm going to try this now. Boom and boom. Okay, perfect. So hopefully you guys are looking at a cash flow statement at this point. I have this cash flow statement available for sale. It's really a standard cash flow statement. So if you can do this one, you can pretty much do any of them. So I'm going to assume that the business is a startup. So the first thing you want to know about the cash flow statement, basically these three rows, are your cash in, okay? And underneath that, you have your cash out. And then you have what they call non-P&L items, usually dividends and loan payouts. Excuse me. So how do we fill this thing out? Well, the first thing you do is you project your sales out, right? So here on this situation over here, I have put in very clear instructions on how to change this. You basically can put in your items. So let's call it a bagel for breakfast, right? Eggs and cheese, right? Et cetera, for lunch. We can hop down here and put hamburger, right? Hot dog. You can put whatever you want here. And another dinner item would be, let's say, pasta, right? Seafood. Right, and then you can set the price. Let's say the pasta is $10. Let's say the seafood is $19, right? And this will change the price over here. This is what I call the market size. So this tells us how many potential customers we can have. So usually look up the demographics in your city or your county, and it'll tell you. So let's say the market size here is, you know, a very small town of 10,000 people. Put the 10,000 people here. Oh, sorry, 10,000. And this is going to change the graph in the other scenario. You can drag this down and make them all 10,000, right? Same thing over here. We can drag that down. And then over here in this column, what you're going to do is you're going to put the penetration. How many do you think you can get out of the town, right? So let's say 1%, right? And 1%, and 1%. And you'll start realizing that if you get 1%, we want to undo that. If you want to undo anything, the button's up here in the left-hand corner, it'll undo that for you, all right? But let's say penetration size for these is 0 and then 0. This is going to change, right? And the bagel is obviously, you know, call it 250, right? Just call it even 2. And then the egg and cheese, call it 6, right? And you'll start seeing that according to the penetration size, if you can penetrate this per month, right, if you can get 1% of the population per month, already just on breakfast, you're making 80,000. And this number should show up here. And exactly, it does, right? It shows up here. So why is this red over here? So that's how you fill out this whole thing. You don't have to touch any of these numbers. Just fill out the other numbers. And I've already projected these numbers to grow at 10%. Right. So if you're looking for just a regular template, this is growing at 10% based off of the previous year, right? Year 3, and then year 3 is based off another 10% off of year 2, and so on and so forth. So that's how you're going to fill out the revenue side. You're going to go to itemized profit breakdown, fill this out, and then it'll give you obviously your revenues here for sales, lunch, dinner, and you can plug any of this stuff into a business plan. If you guys need someone to do this for you, I do this for a living. That's what I do. But I figured I wanted to release some videos on how to do it in case someone didn't want to pay for it, right? Or yeah, just wanted to learn it. So in this column here, we call this the pre-startup column. So when you're first starting a business, this is where you're going to put all of your business expenses, right? So that's the employee section. We'll get to that in a second. So for employees to start, let's say you have to spend $5,000 to attract them and train them, human resources. Let's say for marketing, for some reason, you want to spend $25,000, right? Rent is $2,000. So first month, last month, and security is $6,000. Permits are going to be $2,500, right? And you're going to get these numbers. Oh, $2,500. You're going to get these numbers, obviously, from research, right? And asking people that have done it before. Let's say kitchen equipment is $35,000, right? And what this does is it breaks down your pre-startup expenses. So if you scroll down here, after you're done filling out that column, you'll see these pre-startup expenses start populating, right? So let me fill out a couple more of these just so you can see. So POS system 2,500, let's call it. And I'm just making these numbers up, Again, you would be doing market research or hiring somebody to do market research, right? For this. So hold on, 4,000 beverage inventory, 10,000. Right, POS, let's make that 35 because it's gonna skew the graph. And again, if you scroll down here, you'll start seeing this graph here get filled out, right? So that's how you're gonna fill out your what they call your pre-startup expenses. Because if you notice, this column is right before over here, right, where is month one. Over here is the pre-startup. So basically before you even start operations. And then you're gonna fill out all these things in the yellow with how much your rent is a month, right? 2,000. Let's say there's, you know, a license fee every month. You're probably not gonna need any more kitchen equipment. The POS system might have a monthly subscription fee, et cetera, right? And you're gonna grab this, you just drag these over so you can fill this out. And this will fill that out. And then over here on the graphs and data, what happens is you don't have to touch anything on this page. This will self-populate as long as you do the first part of it, right? And the first part of it, really all you're focused on is the itemized profit breakdown here for the first section for year one. And then the rest will self-populate at a 10% growth rate. For the employees, it's a little bit different because with restaurants, it's important to have your employees counted for. So here, if you go to the employee section, again, the only thing you're changing here is in the yellow. You can put a chef here, right? Call it busboy, waiter. And as you'll notice, it's populating the rest of these things down here, right? And it'll tell you how much you, here, I'm sorry, over here is you have to actually fill out too. So if you fill out this yearly graph is the only thing you have to fill out. Let me change the color on this for you guys. So that's all you have to really fill out. And you can put the chef at, 45,000. And it breaks it down into how much it is weekly, monthly. And it also breaks down over here how much total you spent on employees. And that all gets translated over here. So here is those numbers divided by 12, right? I'm sorry, up here, right here, the salaries for year one and year two and year three and everything else is different. Now, here, what I left here for the marketing section, if you see these numbers here, I put this at 25%. You can change this, but I just wanted to show you guys the formula up here of what works in case you want to change something else to 25%. So for example, some people, when they put their food inventory, they say, well, they factor in their food at 35% of sales or their beverages at 10% of sales. If you want to do that, this is how you do it, right? You multiply that number by, you just literally copy and paste this formula in there and it'll give you the 25% of sales. So, or just change it to 35, right? Depending on what it is. So I just wanted to show you guys that formula, but yeah, it's pretty simple. If you want to know how to read these, again, these are the cash inflow. This is the cash outflow. This is the money you have at the beginning. So here we're negative over here. So we need more money. So let's say we had 120,000 there. Now we're positive and we can cash flow. Now these numbers obviously don't make sense. You want to fill this out, right? But just so you understand. So this is 120,000 you started. Let's say you got a bank loan or an investor. You came down here, you spent all this money to start up your business, right? This is your total amount left. If you look at D38 is the total amount you have left after you started the business. And then you go back up to the top and on E6, you'll see 10,000 again. That's from the previous month. You're gonna add this revenue. It's gonna bring you to this new number. You're gonna subtract these expenses after you fill them out. And it's gonna bring you, if you scroll all the way down, to this number. So after you made all that money up there and you paid out your expenses, this is what you got left, right? And then next month starts, this number will be the same as next month's top number. So you're reading this up and down, right? And then you start up here, you add this money, right? Your breakfast money, and then you subtract this money, right? And then it gives you your monthly cash balance at the end. So what this is showing you, is, again, it says it down here, your cash position at the end of the month. And over here on the top is your cash position at the beginning of the month. So this projection itself is 5 years, right? So you can be in month 36 and just go to year three and you'll see exactly how much you have in the bank account at the end of the month, right? So that's that. I just kind of wanted to give you a quick rundown of how to, look at a restaurant cash flow statement. If you have any questions, check out my links attached. Leave a comment wherever this video is And I hope it was helpful. Visit my websites, nicholascoriano.com or servitude.com. And once again, thanks, guys.